Hi, it's Richard Mosdell. This is my daily karate vlog. I want to talk today about point fighting versus full contact fighting, especially if you're talking about being an amateur or being a pro fighter. So an amateur means you're not going to get paid. Maybe you're on a national team, you get some expenses covered. If you're, let's say, in athletics, 100 meter sprinting, you might get quite a bit of money for showing up at an amateur event, but those all become professional players at that point. In fighting, if you're an amateur player, there's a saying, you're not going to fight if you're going to get injured. If there's the idea that you can get injured on purpose. Of course, amateur boxing, amateur taekwondo, there is the idea of knockout. But you're going into those rules recognizing that A, there is some protection, and B, you understand that you've just walked into a situation where with all the safety in the rules, there will be a full contact hit. But I think what's important, especially in the karate world, is not to have a romantic notion that back 30, 40 years ago, everything was done perfect and strong, and we used to knock guys down. There were a lot more injuries. In the rules the way they are now for karate, the safety that was put in the rules to make them point fighting is because of all the injuries of the past. And because people were less well-trained, so that their sparring partners in the dojo in small amateur sport, and the fact that the referees had less experience or less training, caused more injuries. So the safety is there in the karate competition for sport, for point fighting. Here's the other thing we have to remember. If you have soccer mom and soccer dad who are naive to combat sports and they're putting their kids into a combat sport, even if that combat sport at a high level allows some sort of full contact, or in jiu-jitsu or judo allows a choke, the parent has to be made aware of that. If they're not made aware of that and they're naive to what they're getting into, you're going to have a problem. No matter what, you have to make a decision for yourself. If you're a pro fighter, you're being paid to take the risk of being injured, but there's still rules. There's still things that can and can't happen, right? In boxing, there's a weight of the gloves. In karate fighting now, especially with the World Karate Federation, it is a point fighting exercise. And if you're romantically telling your younger karate students that in the old days we used to hit really hard, we did it with no gloves, and there was a more pure style, we have to be very careful about that, because what we're saying is irresponsible, because we don't want someone to think that once you pass the guard, you have to hurt them so that you've proven you're good at your art. We shouldn't have to hurt somebody else to make ourselves feel better about anything. And this is really important. It's different in a pro fight because they have to show their technique and they're accepting it. But in amateur karate world, we don't hurt the other person. Once you pass the guard, you've passed it. And then we pull back the technique, especially in 99.9% of everything we do. So let's think about that. Let's not get too romantic about the past, because there was a lot of injuries then too. And let's make sure that we can do a lot more with everybody in the club that's safer today. I'm Richard Mosdell. Thanks a lot for watching my vlog. And I really appreciate all the comments. I know I put this up on my Facebook page and we got a lot of great feedback. And I look forward to talking to you tomorrow.